Good morning and hello everybody. First of all, I want to thank you for the possibility of being here today presenting this project. The application of escape room in university teaching has been analyzed in multiple works in recent years in a different fields, starting also in health science. The project we present is developed from a medical clinical case so that the students learn the medical methodology going throughout the different phases of the diagnostic and therapeutic process while they are playing. These projects arise as an initiative to increase the motivation of students through an active experience that makes them look for their own strategies and answers to a problem posed, thus achieving a better assimilation of knowledge. The activity carried out combines the theoretical training of traditional teaching with an educational innovation in which work is carried out cooperatively to solve problems that may arise throughout the professional life of the students. There are many reasons to use an experience like this, adapting the activity to any content, promoting collaboration and teamwork, developing critical and deductive thinking, improving communicative competence, challenging students to persevere, working under controlled pressure, and inquiry-based learning. In this case, it's aimed at sixth-year medical students who have the knowledge about diagnostic procedures, physical examination, and the most prevalent pathologies that will be the subject of the activity. They will advance through different stations proposed, like clinical history, anamnesis, physical examination, interpretation of complementary tests, relying on the previous one to advance, establishing a correct diagnosis and treatment that will save the patient's life, thus being able to live and escape from the classroom. To design an educational escape room, it's necessary to know the characteristics of the students, set the didactic objectives, choose the contents, plan these contents, and finally select the space in which it will be developed. This involves the implementation of the following phases. Phase one, or teacher work, this phase includes design the clinical case, and it's also important testing the scenario to check that everything works properly and no problems are generated, checking that the experience is adjusted in time and form and is reproducible. Second phase of student work. The escape room will end after 16 minutes because the solution has been found or because the available time has finished. The third phase is the briefing, is a feedback, resolution of doubts or difficulties encountered, and a final explication. During the debriefing, the successes and failures of the decision made were discussed, which helped to optimize the learning process. The last phase is number four and is evaluation by the students to know the degree of satisfaction with the experience by a questionnaire with different items as regards organization, training, and others. It's therefore an active and practical format in which both teachers and students are involved. The activity takes place in the teaching area of the Universal Hospital of Camões, into adjoining classroom where students are going to live the educational experience. Each of the classroom will have the same material for the activity that will be arranged on several tables according to the stations. It's carried out by competition in two groups of six people, each supervised by a teacher who competes simultaneously. During the season, each of the teachers will record the course of the game to reinforce the most interesting aspects to be commented in feedback. The estimated duration is 1 hour. The team that makes to get out of the classroom with the key in the shortest time will win, which means that they will have formulated an appropriate diagnosis and treatment that saves the patient's life. The content of the escape room can be as varied as you can. We have chosen the topic of sepsis because it's one of the most prevalent pathology in emergency. Sepsis occurs when an infection sets off a chain reaction throughout the body. The escape room begins with a pre-escape where teacher explains the game, the rules, and the students sign the informed consent for the activity. Now we will see a video in which teachers are preparing the station, checking that everything works correctly, and the entry of the students to begin the pre-escape. Please wait a minute because I have to share the audio video in other presentation. Then the clinical station begins with a duration of 16 minutes. The first station is consideration in emergency triage on sepsis. In this station, we use a crossword so that the students discover the most used terminology in sepsis. In the second station, or the clinical setting, we use codes for pathologs. The third station, or clinical information, allows students to advance through the use of QR codes. The color code is used in the station number 4, or analytical test, where students can interpret the analytical results requested for their patient. At station number 5, a student will be able to access the laboratory results and other complementary tests through a Kahoot. Through numerical codes and their previous knowledge, in the station number 6, students will reach a different diagnosis of what happens to their fictional patient. The prognostic evaluation of sepsis in station number 7 is carried out through observation. And finally, and through the deduction and the rest of tests, they should reach the definitive diagnostic as the outcome of the clinical case. Winners receive an accreditative diploma and a biscuit as a souvenir of the experience. The scores obtained in those referred to the organization of the activity are all of 5 points, the maximum possible score, evaluated by different items like duration of activity, size, method use, design, difficulty, and overall rating. The assessment of the training activity are evaluated by different items like degree of learning, professional application, satisfaction, motivation, integrated vision, and utility. All scores are close to the maximum possible. Some opinions of the student are referred here. All of them will repeat the experience and recommend the experience to other students. They consider that the experience is fun, dynamic, didactic, and positive, that facilitates teamwork, and it's useful and practical experience because resembles a real case. The finally, they consider that this activity is a different way of learning. There are many lessons learned. The first one is effectiveness. The practical integration in the proposed station, as well as the presentation of the data in a different medium than the traditional one, allow a comprehensive and reasoned approach to the proposed case, making the students perceive according to the study an efficiency greater than acquired with classical teaching. Autonomy. The majority opinion of the student is that this methodology improves this personal development with the autonomy that allows them to develop specific competencies, leadership development, and the ability to work in a group. Connection between working life and education. The didactic methodology used by the escape room with a different organized station is a reflection of daily medical practice. Each station gives the key to move on to the next and complement it. Therefore, this methodology used connects perfectly with what are they going to find in their professional life, because opens a window of objective exploration. Improved professional development. The balance between knowledge and practice is essential in medicine. This methodology combines these two aspects perfectly. In this way, when they find themselves in a similar situation in their professional life, they will be able to adapt the situation to previous experience without generating a high level of stress. This results in a personal benefit that will enhance their professional development in the future. And finally, objective view of clinical practice. This educational innovation allows a student to get into the role of the doctor for a limited time of the production of the station. It allows them to get to know that part of medicine that is not taught in books and to work under controlled stress to reach a proper diagnosis and treatment. I wouldn't like to finish without referring this phrase: only succeeds in the world who lives up and searches the circumstances and create them if he can't find them. So let's look for and create a new didactic innovation in the classroom. The escape room is a good alternative. Thank you for your attention.